Hello friends, in this video we are going to assemble and install the piston in John Deere 4045 4 cylinder engine. In this video you will learn how to install the piston, the torque of the piston and the degree torque. First assemble pistons and connecting rods, making sure that the word front on piston and side of connecting rod are facing in same direction. On the piston and the front written on the connecting rod should be on the same side. Insert the piston pin into the piston pin bore. Lubricate the piston pin bore with fresh engine oil and also the connecting rod bush. Always recheck after assembling that front on the piston, top or side of piston and front on connecting rod are facing in the same direction. After assembling the pistons with the connecting rods, always recheck that the front on the connecting rod and the front on the piston are in the same direction, are on the same side. Now install the piston rings, install the expander ring in the bottom groove and install the oil ring over ring expander. The top marked on the oil ring, the number 3 is the oil ring. The top marked on the oil ring will be toward the top of the piston. Install with end gap on opposite side of piston from piston ring expander gap. On the second ring, the top is also marked. Top will be toward the top of the piston. Repeat the process for number 1 ring also. Number 1 ring is also marked with top and 1. The top marked on number 1 piston ring will be toward the top of the piston. If the connecting rods are marked with 1, 2, 3 and 4, install them accordingly. Number 1 will be towards the front of the engine. Remember, number 1 will be towards the front of the engine. Lubricate the piston, the liner and the big end with fresh engine oil. The top compression ring is the keystone compression ring and the second is the rectangular compression ring. Position the gap in keystone compression ring on opposite side of piston from rectangular compression ring. There you can see the gaps are mentioned in the manual. During installation be careful so crankshaft journals and liner valves are not damaged by connecting rod when installing piston rod in liners. Coat pistons, liners and inside of piston with clean engine oil and also recheck that the front on piston and side of the rod faces towards the front of the engine. Push piston down until top ring is into the liner. Carefully pull connecting rod and insert against crankshaft journal. Always dip new connecting rod screws, bolts in clean engine oil and install. Tighten cap screws alternately to initial torque specification. I have already told you the piston ring gap. From the gap in the piston ring compressor, we can see that the top ring is into the liner. Then we will remove the piston ring compressor. Carefully pull connecting rod and insert against crankshaft journal. This connecting rod is marked with 2. This will be installed in number 2 line from the front of the engine. Coat the piston's liners and inside of piston with clean engine oil. This is marked with number 3 and it will be installed at number 3 with front marking on the piston toward the front of the engine. Adjust the ring gap. As mentioned in the manual, if arrow indicating front is not visible on top of piston, install pistons and rod so combustion bowl in piston is offset toward fuel injection pump side of engine and the long side of connecting rod is toward cam side of engine. That is mentioned in the manual. And for your guidance, I have shown it on the screen. Our pistons are marked with the front. Front is written on the top of the piston, so we don't have to face that difficulty. The connecting rod cap screw's initial torque is 58 Newton meter or 43 lb-ft foot pound. Then torque turn all cap screws to 90 to 100 degrees. That is mentioned in the John Deere manual. There you can see we have adjusted it to 44.2 is written on the connecting rod, and we have to rotate it 1.2 points in reverse direction after setting it to 44.2. Do not over torque the cap screws. Tighten cap screws alternately to initial torque. That is the torque angle gauge we are going to use for the degree torque. At the end of this video, I will share the link how to use torque angle gauge or the degree wheel. I will share the link of the video on the method of using the torque angle gauge. The degree torque is 9200 degrees. There you can see we have given a torque of 90 degrees. Now repeat the process for the remaining bolts. Degree torque the bolts alternately on each connecting rod. There you can see it's complete 90 degree. You have the margin of 10 because the manual has mentioned, in the manual it's mentioned that 90 to 100 degrees. We are giving it 90 degrees. Repeat the process on 8 bolts, 2 on each connecting rod. If you don't have this tool for degree torque, you can use alternate method which is mentioned in the manual and I have shown it on the screen. You can read it and apply it. I have applied it on another engine, that is John Deere 6081 engine. I have shared the video so that you can learn the process. Mark on the socket and the connecting rod. One full turn is almost 90 degrees. Here you can see we have marked on the socket and the connecting rod, and we will rotate it. One full turn means 90 degrees. After the initial torque and degree torque, check engine for excessive tightness. Rotate crankshaft several revolutions to be sure engine rotates without excessive tightness. Check liners for deep scratches caused by an improperly installed piston ring or broken piston ring. Thanks for watching the video. Subscribe the channel for more videos like that. If you like the video, share it with your friends who work on the John Deere engines so that they can utilize this video for their guidance and help.